మదర్స్ మిల్క్ బ్యాంక్ నడిపే సుషేనా హెల్త్ ఫౌండేషన్ ఫుడ్ మరియు న్యూట్రిషన్ విభాగము మరియు కెమిస్ట్రీ విభాగము ఫుడ్ సైన్స్ కలిసి గవర్నమెంట్ కళాశాల కోఠి నందు దాత్రి మొబైల్ తల్లి పాల నిధిని ప్రారంభించారు. ఇది దక్షిణ భారతదేశంలోని ప్రప్రథమం. తల్లి పాల నిధి నందు ఎక్కువ పాలు వచ్చే తల్లుల నుంచి పాలు సేకరించి వాటిని ప్యాచరైజేషన్ చేసి తక్కువ పాలు వచ్చే లేక పాలు రాని తల్లుల పిల్లలకు వైద్యుల సలహాపై నీలోఫర్ ఆసుపత్రి నందు ఇవ్వడం జరుగుతుంది. అంతేకాకుండా తల్లులకు పాలివ్వడం గురించి, పాల కోసం మంచి ఆహారం గురించి, అలవాట్ల గురించి వివరిస్తారు. బిడ్డలు బాగా ఎదగడం కోసం పిల్లల్ని ఛాతి మీద ఉంచుకునే కంగారు మదర్ కేర్ అనే ప్రక్రియను కూడా తల్లులకు, వారి కుటుంబ సభ్యులకు నేర్పిస్తారు. ఈ సేవలు కేవలం నీలోఫర్ ఆసుపత్రిలోనే కాకుండా దూర ప్రాంతాల తల్లులు పిల్లలకు కూడా అందాలని ఒక పాల నిధిని వ్యాన్లో అమర్చి పంపే ప్రయత్నం మొదలైంది. ఈ సందర్భంగా యూనివర్సిటీ కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ విమెన్ కోటి వారు సుషేనా హెల్త్ ఫౌండేషన్ వారితో కలిసి న్యూట్రిషన్ మరియు ఫుడ్ సైన్స్ చదివే విద్యార్థులకు శిక్షణ, ఉద్యోగ అవకాశాలు, పరిశోధన గురించి ఒక అవగాహన పత్రంపై సంతకాలు చేశారు. ఈ సందర్భంగా ముఖ్య అతిథిగా కరుణా వాకాటి ఐఏఎస్ కమిషనర్, ఆరోగ్య మరియు కుటుంబ సంక్షేమ శాఖ అల్లూరి వెంకటరంగరాజు, ఎన్సీసీ సంస్థ మేనేజింగ్ డైరెక్టర్, ఆ సంస్థ డైరెక్టర్ సుబ్బరాజు, సుషేనా హెల్త్ ఫౌండేషన్ అధ్యక్షులు డాక్టర్ శ్రీనివాస్ మూర్కి, ఆ సంస్థ కార్యదర్శి డాక్టర్ సంతోష్ కుమార్ ప్రాలేటి, సినీ నటి నభా నటేష్, డాక్టర్ విద్యుల్లత ప్రిన్సిపల్, డాక్టర్ కవిత వైస్ ప్రిన్సిపల్, డాక్టర్ ఎం దుర్గా ప్రసాద్, క్రాంప్టన్ గ్రీన్స్ సిఎస్ఆర్ఆర్ హెడ్ శ్రీమతి సీమా పవాస్కర్, డాక్టర్ భవానీ కలవలపల్లి ప్రసంగించారు. ఎన్సిసి ఎన్ఎస్ఎస్ విద్యార్థులు మంచి ప్రదర్శన చేశారు.
ఐ కంగ్రాచులేట్ కోటి విమెన్స్ కాలేజ్. ఆల్ ఆఫ్ us are students. The first time I was exposed to what the status of women or poverty etc. was after I joined service. That's how much insulated the educational institutions are from what is happening in the country and development of the country. So it's very, very nice to see that young students and faculty are getting involved with actual action on the development of this country and especially maternal health issues. So I congratulate the principal and also the faculty who had come to me and the health and nutrition department of the Koti Women's College. This is a very welcome step. Also congratulate the Sushena Foundation, Dr. Santosh, Dr. Srinivas, Kashinath Garu. We've been associated with from the health department. Dr. Santosh in many ways has been, this is my second term as commissioner. The first term, his insights into healthcare did help me to gain knowledge on various aspects, not just maternal health. He's very passionate about a whole lot of other aspects of healthcare, and that's been very, very useful to me as a professional and personally. The Nilofer Milk Bank has played a very, very critical role in not just feeding 10,000 babies as was said earlier, but has also given us a policy level insight, and I am very happy to share that the Telangana government, we have decided to set up milk banks all across the state in all the 33 districts. About 10 are currently under construction, and we are going to make it functional. I am also happy to share with you and thankful to Dr. Srinivas, President of NNF, who's agreed to help us technically in pasteurizing the milk and also to train our personnel to handle it. So by saying this in the public space, I am completely binding you, so you can't get out of this. So while we have made great strides, Telangana state law, after the state has been formed in the last 3 years, maternal mortality rate, I am very proud to say that maternal mortality rate dip has been the highest in the country. We have dropped by 17 points. So we are right behind, just behind Tamil Nadu. We are at 63, they are at 60. They have been working on public health for the last 15 years. But this very, very sharp drop has been because of the absolute commitment of our Honorable Chief Minister. We've had KCR kit, introduction of whole lot of initiatives, standardization of labor rooms, mobile vehicles for pregnant women for their ANCs, and whole lot of labor room practices, which has ensured that the maternal mortality rate drop has been the highest. Increase in public institutional deliveries, again, Telangana stands number one in the country. This is as per the latest SRS. However, NFHS 5 says that breastfeeding is at 37% in Telangana, so which is very, very counterintuitive, because you think the instinct of the mother is to feed the child, but somewhere something has happened and we have gone downhill. So this whole initiative of bringing out this whole concept of breast milk out in the open, talking about it, and this kind of initiatives, in my view, the milk bank is really the transformative intervention which will ensure that mother's milk and breast milk are propagated across the state and hopefully across the country. As Dr. Srinivas was saying, as we discussed today and as we've had discussions across the country somehow, for various reasons, maybe C-sections, maybe the fact that mothers go out and work whole lot of other cultural and socio-economic issues, breast milk has been one thing which has been on the decline, and if we do not address this, we will not go very far in terms of the IMR, etc. So this is going to be, in my view, a one transformational intervention from the side of all of us. So in this connection, I would like to thank the corporate sector. It's only when society in all its dimensions and aspects comes together that a real firm step is taken forward. So this constructive partnership between private commitment-driven individuals and professionals that Sushena has, and educational institutions and government, we will be able to move forward in a very, very constructive manner. From my side, from the government, we are all very passionately committed to maternal health, and we were just in the tribal areas about 1 week ago, and if you actually see the situation, you wonder if there is any development that has taken place at all. You see the Gutikoyas in deep forests. IMR, MMR are three times, four times what we have in the general areas. So we have a long way to go, but I think all of us together will definitely be able to achieve knowledge, commitment, compassion, and professionalism. All of us together, we should be able to make it. So I congratulate Sushena Foundation once again. I congratulate you, madam, for having this initiative in an educational institution. And I thank all of you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
I'm really, really happy to be here, to be a part of such a noble event. As we all know, as a human, and the basic thing is when we're just born is the nutrition. And for various reasons, there has been deprivation in, the natural breast milk in a lot of women. And it's very easy to reach out to, bottled milk and get away with it. But it always has a long-term, effect on a baby. But this initiative, which is taken by... Sushena Health Foundation, is so appreciable. It is such a, a noble gesture to have bottled breast milk and to make it reach to the needy and to reach to the babies who require it, so that they have like a bright future. And I think I am really, really, really happy to be a part of such amazing, event. And also, it's such an amazing, thing from the college side to make all the women and young girls aware of the importance of breast milk, so that in the future they bring the children to the country who will be strong and who will take our country, who are responsible to take our country forward, and you know that. The youth are responsible to build the country stronger and take it higher. So now I was just given a couple of Telugu sentences, and I want you all to say it along with me. Talli palu muddu, dabba palu vaddu. One more time. Talli palu muddu, dabba palu vaddu. And say it to all your friends, all your who all you know, that this has been done for a cause. This is done for the growth of the country and growth of our children and the health of our children. Thank you so much.
మరిన్ని లేటెస్ట్ అప్డేట్స్ కోసం జీకే మీడియా ఛానల్ని వెంటనే సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి. నోటిఫికేషన్స్ కోసం బెల్ బటన్ని క్లిక్ చేయడం మర్చిపోకండి.